Okay, so we're looking for a projection matrix, right? And so this is our A, which is comprised of the two vectors, V1 and V2, which span the plane, okay? And now we're gonna look for P, which is going to be the projection matrix that will project any vector upon that plane, right? So first, let's start off with A transpose A. Okay. 3, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. Now acting upon A, now 3, 1 acting upon this, that would be 3 times 3, which is 9, and 9 plus 1, which would be 10. And that would be a 3, 1, 0, 0, that would be a 3, and that would be a 1. Okay. All right. So then what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to augment this with the identity matrix, 10, 3, 3, 1, augmented with 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, so I would have to multiply this times negative 3 over 10, we're going to be 10. 3, augment 1, 0, that would be negative 3 divided by 10. That would turn that into, well, that wouldn't be effective, that would just stay as 1. And that would turn that into a 0. Okay. All right. Now, multiplying 3 times negative 3 divided by 10 would be, give you a negative 9 divided by 10. All right. Now, negative 9 divided by 10 plus 1, that would be negative 9 over 10, plus 10 over 10, which would be 1 over 10. Okay. Let's go ahead and multiply this guy by 10. And so we would get Ten, three, zero, one, augmented 1, 0, and then that would be a negative 3 and a 10. Okay. Then we would want to multiply by negative 3 and add upwards. And so that would be a negative 3, and that would be a 10, that would be a negative 30, and then negative 3 times negative 3 is a positive 9, 9 plus 1 is 10. Okay, and then we'd have to divide this by 10. We'll just shift this up. So from there we would get 1, 0, 0, 1 augmented with 1, -3, -3, and 10. Okay. All right. Now, once you've done this part of the problem, what you really want to do before going on to the next step of this problem, check your work. Just make sure you actually have the correct inverse matrix. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna check our work let's have this act upon its inverse. Okay, so 10 acting upon 1 is 10, then 3 acting upon negative 3 is negative 9. So that would turn that into a 1. That would be a negative 30 and a positive 30. That would be a positive 3 and a negative 3. And then 3 and 1, that would be a negative 9 and a 10. Comes out to a 1. Okay. It's just a good idea to go ahead and check your work at that point of the problem. And so to know that you really did get the correct inverse matrix. Multiplying them should give you the identity matrix. Okay. Now, we're going to go to A and then A transpose A inverse. A transpose. Okay, and so that would become 3, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, negative 3, 10, and now this is going to act upon, that's 3, 1, 0. And so let's do these first. So that's 3, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. Okay, 1 and negative 3, that would be a 0, and that would be a 1. And that would be a 0. So negative 3 acting upon 3 would be a negative 9, and a 10 would turn that into a 1. And then negative 3, 10 acting upon this one would be negative 3, 0. Okay, so 3, 1 acting upon that one would be 1. 3, 1 acting upon this one would be 0, and then be 0. Now 1, 0 acting upon this one, that would turn that into a 0. 1, 0 acting upon this one would turn into a 1. And 1, 0 acting upon that one would be 0. Be a 0, a 0, a 0. Okay. Now, the very last part of the problem is saying, okay, well, we had this projection, and what is this projection? This is the projection upon the xy plane. And so, if we're going to take the vector v3 and have it project upon the plane, okay, so we're at this point in the problem right now, and so the last part is to project it. And what would that do? It'll squash the z component of the problem. So that would become 12 and then 13 and 0. So the projection upon the xy plane, what does it do? It squashes the z component and forces that vector down onto the xy plane. Okay?